Okay, everybody. It was my birthday a little bit back, and people gave me money, and I bought me something off of eBay. Something I've been wanting for a couple of years, but I am so terrible. I will not pay full price for things when they're real expensive, rarely, even when they're not, because I'm such a penny pincher when it comes to that kind of thing. And so, I found it where a guy had found one at an estate sale, and then he posted it on eBay. Ooh, look, y'all. Lots of bubble to put on my soap. Oh, everybody's soap's going to be wrapped in bubble now. All right. How to get it out. Let's see. Okay, so drum roll, it's an Excalibur dehydrator. I've been watching YouTube videos, and they said that you could take one of these and, oh, isn't it beautiful? It's just beautifully wrapped. Look at that. Where did I put the knot? Okay, they said you could take an Excalibur dehydrator, and you could, like, when you buy your vegetables, you know how you're always throwing away things? Well, they said that you could take your extra like vegetables, like the vegetables, it's like, I know I'm not going to use them before they go bad, and you could put them in the dehydrator and then put them in a sealed container, and then when you made like vegetable soup or things like that, you could, I'm trying not to cut the bubble, y'all. Bubble can be expensive. I like to recycle. And so anyway, they said you could take and then put it in vegetable soup or rehydrate it, and it would look just like it did when you, before you dehydrated it. It would come back to complete normal. And so, and you know, I'm always having apples and blueberries and the farmer's market, they're always having, you know, vegetables and things. And so anyway, so I thought, well, you know, I could find, you know, when I find a bargain, and also, ooh, look at that nice bubble. That's just perfectly cut to wrap up some soap in. Anyway, so this one's used, and I'm going to use it for dehydration. And I've always wanted to make homemade apple dried pies, and so now I can. And my husband's a truck driver, and he's always bringing in fruit and produce that he gets from where he loads in California. And so I'm so excited. I don't know how I'm going to get this thing open yet. I mean, anyway, so I thought I would do a few videos on how to and show you how I do it and what it turns out like, and then we'll put it in, we'll reconstitute it and cook with it and see how it comes out. So I'm going to make several videos, and also I'm going to put one bar of freshly made soap in there and see how it cures soap. Anybody that knows how that works, or if they've ever tried it, I would love you to comment, you know. I mean, it could be something that people have already tried, and it's a total failure. But I thought, well, you know, it dehydrates. That means it it takes the moisture away, and I might be able to cut my drying time down to just one night compared to 3 days. So this is something to check out. Okay, I'm gonna cut the camera off. You've seen enough, and we will, and I'll open it up the rest of the way. Okay, this is my Excalibur trays out, all but one. I didn't need one of them. And what I did was, is I took this bowl and I put equal parts of teriyaki, soy sauce, Moore's marinade, that's sort of like Dale's, but it has less salt, Worcestershire sauce. I put half, what I put of this, I put half in spicy brown mustard. Then I put a couple of tablespoons of coarse ground black pepper. And about 4 tablespoons of powdered garlic. That's this. And then I put in about half of what I put in with the soy sauce and the teriyaki, because I put equal parts of those. I put half of the liquid smoke. That's the mesquite liquid smoke. And it was just a fun recipe. It's with the stuff I had in the kitchen, in the refrigerator, and I thought, hey, let's just mix it all together and see what happens. I mean, I don't know, I find that to be quite fun. And I had some frozen cubed steak deer meat. And we had put this deer up ourselves. My husband killed it this year, and he butchered it or dressed it, and then I butchered it up, and I cubed it and put it in the freezer. And so I completely thawed it to where it was not frozen in any way, and then I just put enough of those ingredients on top to cover it well in the bowl. And then I let it soak all day, because it's night, and I was opening that box up this morning when I first got up. And then I just sort of cut them up a little bit into smaller pieces than the cube steak would have been. And then I just thought, you know, I had a couple of peaches, I had one banana, and we weren't sure if we were going to like banana that didn't have like honey or sugar water on it. So I thought, well, I'm going to just put one ripe banana in there and just see what we think about banana chips that's made without any sugar. Same thing with the peach and an apple. I thought, well, let's just see, because let's just see what we think of it without putting any kind of anything on it. Now, I have been told that it is best to put, let me get that out here, some kosher salt, not table salt, lightly on the meat. So I thought I'd let you see me do that. There's so many videos out there of people taking forever cutting meat up and doing their mixes that I thought you would appreciate. Just that's what I dumped in there, and I did it randomly. And they said to lightly salt it, and with this, and I don't know how I'm doing it lightly or not, but they said it really helped the curing process, the salt, and it really made it good. And so I have lightly salted every piece of the meat. And I didn't go for any uniform pieces because this was cubed deer meat. I suppose if I ever bought meat like on discount, I'd probably maybe try to cut it up more perfectly, but this is all pretty much the same thickness mostly, because I beat it myself with a cuber and got it all, you know, flattened out really nice. And I let it marinate for like 8 hours. And on all the videos, or most of the videos, like some videos, they just put it on, stick it in the thing. And then other videos, they're like, on YouTube, they're like, left you for like 12 to 24 hours in the refrigerator. But, you know, me and my patience. So anyway, so I thought, well, you know, what the hey? Let's just, you know, 8 hours, let's see what happens. And so the meat was free. So let's see what happens. So let's put it in the dehydrator. Okay, so I've put all the little trays. I put the meat on the bottom because I didn't want the meat to drip on the fruit. And I think technically, according to the controls, there's like meat, vegetable, fruit. So I think you're not supposed to do like more than one thing at the same time. But I thought, oh, what the hey, it's just the first time, we're playing, we're having fun, let's give it a whirl. So anyway, my dishwasher is screaming. Can you hear that? And the phone's ringing. So hang on, I'll bring you right. Okay. So the dishwasher quit screaming. I'm not sure what was going on with it. I opened it and closed it and it quit. Anyway, I also put one tray of apples and I put one apple with the peeling on because I really love to eat peelings and I'm not sure though, it may not be worth 2 cents in a dehydrator. And this is the Excalibur dehydrator and it is just in perfect condition. I'm so tickled with it. I got this for $80 on a bid on eBay. And then it cost $26 for the shipping. And I'm going to take this off the thing. So it's going to be a little wobbly there for a minute. And then back here is the controls. And I knew that was going to be a hard thing to cope with. But I figured that I could just lift it out and do it each time I did it. So let's see if I can. Because I really liked the idea of having it so convenient and having it right here above my microwave so that I could put things in it real easy. And I put it on this wooden cookie board sheet. And so it says for meat, I need to put it in mauve burgundy color. So that's what I did. And now I'm going to slide it back in. And you can see it doesn't have a lot of noise. It's really, really, really light on the noise. And I don't know if this is the way they come or not, but on this one, all I got was the nonstick. I didn't get the little extra tray with one of them. So we'll just have to see. I may have to purchase one of those. This is for fruit roll-ups. It's a nonstick thing. And so it may not do good for just putting fruit and things on. And so I got the fruit on the top, the meat on the bottom. And I'm going to put the lid on it. And I'm going to go to bed. But I'm told it takes 6 to 8 hours in a regular one. But I haven't seen the time yet for an Excalibur. And because I bought it used on eBay, I didn't get the manual. But I can purchase that off the Excalibur website, so I probably will. In any case, we're just going to see how it does. This is for fun. So let's see what happens. I'll bring you back as we check along. Okay, I wanted to just go over this recipe one more time so that you'll know what's in it in case we don't like it. Or if we do like it. Equal parts of teriyaki, soy, Moore's marinade, which is for steaks and beef, and Worcestershire sauce. Then, half the amount that I put of those, I put in spicy brown mustard and liquid smoke. And then I put several tablespoons of coarse black pepper and garlic powder. No garlic salt. Then I sprinkled it with the kosher salt. Lightly. Now, I was just going to tell you a hint about this. If you're a penny pincher too, like I am, when you go to buy coarse ground black pepper, it is so expensive, like $5 for just a little bitty bottle. But you can buy the unground pepper seeds, you know, just peppercorns, I guess they call them, in the same size jar for half or even less than half. And then I put them in my bullet which is, or you can put them in a food processor or a coffee grinder or a blender, and then make your own coarse ground black pepper. This container has a lid on it, so it keeps it fresher. And that's how I make my own coarse ground black pepper without having to pay that ungodly price. Okay, so that's what I put in it. And I'll bring you back and we'll find out how long it takes, if we like it, all that good stuff. This is just for fun. Okay, bye. Okay, everybody, it's the next morning. And I was supposed to wake up in the middle of the night and check on the fruit. And I didn't. I was supposed to set an alarm. So let's see what the apples look like. You want to try one?
Sure.
My husband hates everything, so if he likes it. Oh, it's good. A good snack. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Try one with the peeling on it.
No.
My husband hates peelings, but try it with the peelings. See if you think it's any different. He took a little bitty bite. Come on, get over here in the camera.
Oh, well.
Come on, you can do it for YouTube.
Okay.
Did you notice any difference with the peeling on as the peeling off?
A little more of the apple taste with the peeling on.
Oh, so I thought it had better flavor too. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that was the apples. I think we might have really well done the bananas because I left them in there for 8 hours.
They're stuck too.
Well, that's normal.
They don't feel like they're done enough.
Oh, Lord, they taste good.
They do.
They taste better than the ones you buy in the store.
All right, time for the jerky.
Wait just a minute. You haven't tried a peach.
That's good too.
Oh, well, you're on the camera now.
Oh, you sold me. It's good.
All right, now let everybody see what those look like. Now, I think, see how they turned brown a little bit, the bananas? But now the peaches didn't. I think the peaches look fine. But the peaches are not like really hard. They're like really, they're still rubbery a little bit. I don't know. It could be because it needs to cool. And it could be because they need to do some more.
I think they need to do some more.
But I really like them just as to eat snack.
Oh, that's good, yeah.
With that little bit of flexibility to them.
Yeah.
Mmm.
I don't know how they would preserve.
Well, you know, some
like that.
But some people do these for snacks that they're only going to preserve for a few months compared to a year.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay. Let's get the camera up here. Total drum roll. Let's see what the jerky looks like.
It looks like jerky.
Looks like jerky. Wait, not yet. Back up. Okay, step in the picture. Now.
Okay.
Wait a minute. Okay, now. This recipe was a homemade recipe, and you may just totally hate the recipe. My husband hates everything.
That's good.
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
Scale of 1 to 10?
Mm-hmm. At least 8.
It is good. Mm-hmm. It's a little tougher, I think, than what it should have been, because I think maybe 6 hours would have been better than 8.
You were bad.
I was bad. But I think that we got the right click. And that's it breaking loose. And do you think it could have handled a little bit more liquid smoke?
Maybe.
Maybe just a little bit more liquid smoke.
Did you put garlic on it?
I did.
Maybe a little more garlic too.
We're garlic freaks though, y'all, because I can really taste the garlic. So if you're not garlic freaks, don't put more garlic on it.
I love garlic. And garlic is heart smart.
And I think, I think it could have used more black pepper.
No, it's got enough of that.
No, you're right. I can taste the back of your tongue. What it is it's the soy sauce and the it's the soy sauce part that it needs more, isn't it? Maybe, well, I only marinated it for 8 hours. Mm-hmm. If I had marinated it for 12 hours, like it said, then that might have been stronger in it.
It's really good, though.
It is. It's awesome. Okay, everybody. That was our little experiment. And if you're watching this video and you've never watched any of my videos, I make homemade soap and other kind of beauty products. So check out my channel. And if you like this video, please hit like and share it on Facebook or Twitter or whatever else there is out there. And please subscribe. And please check out all my other videos. Bye, YouTube. All right, there's my soap, all stacked up. If you would like to buy a bar, just go to my website. There's a link in the description at the beginning and the end of each video. Have a great day.